Vsauce! Kevin here. The toothbrush dates back to at least the ancient Babylonians and Egyptians who frayed the end of a stick to scrub their teeth. But in the 15th century, the Chinese invented something closer to the modern toothbrush, using bristles from pig's necks attached to a bone or bamboo handle. Pig or horse hair was used for toothbrushes until nylon was invented in 1938. Ancient toothpaste recipes have ranged from the ashes of burnt mice heads and eggshells to more abrasive crushed bone and oyster shell concoctions of Greeks and Romans. In the 1800s, toothpaste was actually a powder containing soap and chalk, and it wasn't until 1890 that tubes with paste came into the picture. But unfortunately, the tubes were often made of lead, which leaked into the toothpaste. And in case you still got a cavity, Ozark folklore held the belief that carrying the jawbone of a donkey in your teeth and walking backwards could cure a toothache. The Chinese have been making a form of toilet paper since at least the 2nd century by mixing mulberry bark, hemp, and rags with water, mashed into a pulp, then pressed and hung to dry in the sun. But other cultures have wiped with everything from sticks, moss, and corn cobs to pebbles carried in a special bag or a sponge on a stick dipped in a bucket of salt water. When New Yorker Joseph Gaetti invented aloe-infused sheets of manila hemp to prevent hemorrhoids in 1857, the public scoffed at the idea because why pay for wiping paper when they already had old newspapers? TP eventually caught on because of the advent of the flush toilet and people needing a paper that navigated plumbing. And pages from the Sears Roebuck catalog just clogged the pipes. But there was a time where you didn't flush urine, you collected it to wage wars. Urine contains saltpeter, which along with charcoal and sulfur creates gunpowder. Outhouses and cities had trays under the seats that were pulled out from behind, and night soil collectors came by and emptied the contents into a wagon, where it was delivered to concrete tanks to recover the saltpeter. During the Civil War in the US, while the men of the South were off fighting, the women were doing their part by collecting their urine, a contribution immortalized in poems. What could make a Yankee soldier sadder than dodging bullets fired by a pretty woman's bladder? And as always, thanks for watching.